Hi friends, it's me, Megan, and I'm Jessie.
Jessie, where did you get that dollar?
My grandma gave it to me.
Nice. What do you plan to do with your dollar?
Well, there's a man at the park who always holds a sign asking for money. I was thinking about giving it to him.
Oh, Jessie, that's so kind of you to think of that man. In today's Bible story, Peter and John met a man at the temple, and he was asking people for money.
Oh, did Peter and John give him a dollar?
No, they actually gave him something much better. Listen to the story. One day, Peter and John went to the temple to pray. They saw a man sitting by the gate. The man could not walk, so every day his friends carried him to the temple. As people went into the temple, the man asked them for money since he could not work. The man asked Peter and John for help. Peter said, "Look at us." The man looked at Peter and John. He thought they were going to give him money. "I do not have silver or gold," Peter said. But Peter did have something better. "In the name of Jesus, get up and walk." Peter helped the man up. The man was healed. His feet were strong, and he could walk and jump. Then the man went into the temple with Peter and John, walking, leaping, and praising God. Everyone who saw the man was amazed. This was the man who could not walk and sat at the gate, but now he could walk. How could such a wonderful thing happen? The next day, the religious leaders met together. They asked Peter and John, "How did you heal this man?" Peter was filled with the Holy Spirit and said, "This man was healed by the power of Jesus." Then Peter told the religious leaders that Jesus is the most important one of all. The religious leaders did not know what to say. They told Peter and John to be quiet and to stop telling people about Jesus. But Peter said, "We cannot keep quiet. We must tell people what we have seen and heard." Peter and John met with other believers and prayed that God would give them power to be brave and tell people about Jesus. After Jesus went back to heaven, the Holy Spirit gave Jesus' followers power to begin working. With the power of Jesus' name, Peter healed a man who could not walk. The religious leaders could not stop Jesus' followers from telling people the good news about Jesus.
Hi everyone, welcome back. Did you like that story with Megan and Jesse? They told us about Peter and how he healed a man. Well, first what happened? This had happened after Jesus went back to heaven. And he left Peter and the disciples, and they could do incredible things because they had the power from Jesus. So, Peter and John decided to go to the temple to pray. When they got there, they saw a man was sitting there. We're going to pretend this is our man right here. And he couldn't walk. His legs did not work at all. They never have. He just could not walk. So he couldn't work. So what can he do? All he could do was sit outside and just beg for money and hope that somebody would put some money in there so he could get something to eat and so he could live. Well, when Peter and James came and he said, "Please, can you give me some money?" And they said, "No, we don't have any money to give you, but we can give you something else instead." So how did this man get to the temple if he couldn't walk? Well, he must have had some good friends who carried him very carefully every day to the temple. Perhaps like this. They would grab hold and they would carry him to the temple and carefully set him up so that he could sit there all day long and ask for money. So when Peter and John came, they said, "We can't give you money, but we can do something else instead. In the name of Jesus, rise up and walk." And do you know what happened? Little by little, the man stood up. His legs were holding him up and he could stand. And then all of a sudden he could walk. He probably was jumping with excitement. And he went into the temple and showed everybody. They couldn't believe he was the same man. But he was. Peter had healed the man, but using God's power, Jesus' power, that the Holy Spirit was inside of him. How excited he must have been. He must have rejoiced and been so excited. Well, we can do a little activity to help us remember this, and you can do it too. You're going to need just two things. Paper. Perhaps you can get your favorite color or whatever you have. And you're going to need a shoe. Yes, a shoe. Just one. One's good enough. Now, this isn't mine, but I just borrowed it. So what we need to do is take the shoe. We're going to trace it on the paper. Do you think you could do that? Or you can trace your foot too. That would work also. If we trace our shoe on the paper all the way around, then if you have your scissors or if you want your mom to cut this out for you, we can cut out our shoe carefully. And what are we going to do with this? It's going to be kind of a game, and it's going to remind us that Peter healed this man with the power of Jesus, and he was able to rise up and walk. So when I cut this out, and we could make more, you see we have footsteps like this. What you can do is you can take them, and if you have a lot, you can put them down and put them through your house, and then the idea is you have to follow the footsteps. Maybe you could make a game for somebody in your family, and they have to jump from footstep to footstep, and then they can say, "What is this game?" And you can tell them. This game is because we learned today that Peter, in Jesus' name, had the man rise up and walk. So it's kind of like a walking game. Well, we've been learning about the Holy Spirit, but how does the Holy Spirit help Christians? Do you know? He helps comfort us, he shows us our sin, and he guides us as we live for God's glory. That's the Holy Spirit's job, and we want the Holy Spirit to live within us. So thank you for paying attention, and remember, Jesus loves you, and so do I. Until next time.